Some people say that it doesn't matter which to-do list app you use, but that's only half true. It's true that there's not one app that is the best app for everyone, but at the same time, some apps are a heck of a lot better than other apps. One app that I haven't talked about much before, but that is actually a great choice for many people, is Todoist. Let me show you why you should consider using Todoist for your to-do list. Okay, we're here on the Mac, and we're looking at Todoist on the Mac, and on the right here, I've got some things that I want to hit in this video, so let's go through those things. First of all, it's very easy to capture tasks with Todoist, and of course, if you're not getting tasks into your system, if you're not capturing them, you'll never get around to doing them, so capturing tasks is extremely important. Todoist has a very good quick add feature that I can pull up with the keyboard shortcut Command Control A, and it's right here, and I can pull that up regardless of whether I have Todoist open or not. And then I can start typing things. For example, I can say, send my clothes in for laundry service. And then I can add task, and now that gets added to my inbox right here, okay? So that's pretty cool. However, I can do more than that because Todoist has really good natural language recognition. Let me delete that task and try that again. I'm gonna do the same keyboard shortcut to pull up quick add, and I'm going to say send my clothes in for laundry service tomorrow. Now you see that tomorrow gets highlighted and the due date for this task actually gets set at tomorrow. Amazing, right? But we can even go further. I can also type a hashtag and then start typing home to assign this to my home area. You'll see, or home project. On the list over here, I've made a bunch of projects to organize my to-dos, to organize my life, and one of them is home. This is a home task. So now I can add that task, and that task will live in home. And if I go to my upcoming view, you'll see that it's actually listed under tomorrow. So it's very easy to capture tasks with quick add and natural language recognition. Now, another thing I really like a lot about Todoist is, let's say I'm in the inbox and I come up with multiple things to do. It's very easy to write down multiple tasks right after the other. So I click add task over here. And then let's say I want to make a Todoist course, question mark. In fact, if you'd like me to do this, let me know. Boom. And as I hit enter or return, I can immediately start typing another task. I'm gonna say make a Fantastical course. I'm gonna show you around Fantastical. Not show you around, I'm gonna show you the app a little bit later. Boom. And maybe I come up with more things and I can just keep typing and keep hitting enter and list a lot of things. Really handy if you just came from a meeting, for example, and you didn't really take meeting notes, but there's a lot of stuff in your head, you can get to tasks on paper really fast. Another cool thing about Todoist is, let's just go to this task right here, is that you can attach files or record your voice and attach that to a task. It's a little bit hidden how you do that. The way you do that is you actually comment on a task. So if I click here, then I can say attach a file, I can record audio, or I can insert emoji, and here's some integrations that maybe we'll talk about, maybe we won't. Let's see. Now, you might wonder, why is there a comment feature for a task? That's because there's some collaboration features in Todoist, and we'll get back to that in a minute as well. Anyway, you can attach stuff to tasks. That's really big. Not every to-do list app lets you do that. So if you often find yourself wanting to record a voice note to remind yourself later when you're going to do the task about something that was important, hey, Todoist might be a good choice for you. Okay, Todoist is available on all platforms. So not just right here, we have a Mac app, but there's also a Windows app, and it's available on Android, on iPhone, iPad, all that stuff. Actually, let me open up Google Chrome right here. And this is Todoist inside Google Chrome. So there's an excellent web interface as well. This can be great if you're forced to use different platforms, for example, at home and in your work life. You'll see that it looks pretty much the same. That's because it is pretty much the same right here. So if I go back to the inbox, you'll see that the inbox really looks the same. Super handy though that Todoist is available anywhere. Now, the next thing I want to show you is that Todoist has a two-way calendar integration. And I'll tell you what that means. And I'm going to show you that first inside Google Calendar and then in Fantastical, which is the calendar app that I use. So if I open Google Calendar right here, you'll see that I have a calendar called Todoist. Now, I'm not going to show you how to set this up, but after you set this up, this is what it looks like. The Todoist tasks that I have scheduled for today show up as all day tasks right here. The ones that I've scheduled for tomorrow show as all day tasks right there. So this is sort of useful, but you can do something much cooler. Here's this YouTube video that I'm recording right now, and you'll see that inside Todoist, this is a task that I have for today. It's a task with a bunch of subtasks, in fact. We have a bunch of subtasks right here. That's another very cool feature of Todoist. And subtasks themselves can have subtasks, so you can drill really deep, and I like that a lot. Anyway, this is scheduled for today, right? It's the first thing on my plate, you know, at this point of my day. So if I go back to Google Chrome and I'm here inside my calendar, Google Calendar, what I can do is I can actually edit this event. And I can say, rather than this being an all-day event, let's say it's 4:15, let's say I'm gonna start this at 4, and I'm gonna do this from 4 to 5. So 1 hour, and then I click save. Now this task sits on my calendar right here, so you can kind of do some time blocking. Now, I don't necessarily think that you should be time blocking every single task individually. That's a really, how should I say it? That's a dangerous way to time block, because stuff happens throughout the day and it's very hard to estimate how long individual tasks are gonna take. But anyway, if you are very calendar driven, if your days are very calendar driven, this might appeal a lot to you. Now, if I go back to Todoist, you'll see that this task has actually been set for today at 4 p.m. That's cool, right? So you can set not just the due date, but also a due time. Now, let me just say, you know what? Actually, I wanna do this today at 5:30. And then I do that and I click save. Now, if I go back to Google Chrome, you'll see that it's gonna take a little while to sync, but bam, it bounces to 5:30. So there's that nice two-way synchronization. Okay, now let's see how this looks in my favorite calendar app, which is Fantastical. I'll tell you right off the bat, Fantastical is only available on Apple devices. So if you don't use Apple devices, it's not gonna be there for you, I'm sorry. But this is Fantastical over here. You'll see something that's very similar. I know there's a lot going on, but let's take a look. Fantastical has, you know, a little calendar picker over here and has this sidebar where it's showing my to-dos for today in here, which is because this integrates with Todoist. I'll show you, by the way, if you just go to settings and then if you go to accounts, you can set up, you can integrate Todoist directly with Fantastical. So there's a great direct integration, works really well. And you'll see, I can see, hey, you know what? These are my tasks for today. And these are my events for today. And if I've put a task at a specific time, either inside Fantastical or inside Todoist, then these are all sorted by time. So yeah, so I have a coffee with CC at 2, record the video at 5:30, dinner with friends at 7:30. So this can be a great way to plan your day. And I can look ahead of time as well, right? I can see this is what I've got going on tomorrow, Friday, Saturday, and such. Now, if I go to the day view, this might be a bit easier. If your days tend to be very busy, you might prefer to plan your day this way rather than in the week view. And you can start, you know, you can just drag this on here, by the way. If I want to do this at 1, I can just drag this task and say I'm going to do that at 1. But like I said, scheduling a time for every single to-do, that might be asking for trouble. But hey, give it a go. Maybe that'll work really well for you. Okay, let's go back to Todoist and minimize Fantastical. And one other thing that I really like is you can customize how you view projects. So we'll go back to Todoist and let's say that here I have a project called YouTube videos. Okay, I've made this into a Kanban board. So let's say here's the YouTube videos that are currently ideas. Here's the YouTube videos that I'm writing. Well, here's what I'm filming, but actually this one, of course, I'm filming it at the moment. Boom, so I can drag it in there and I can do this. Now, in the past, I've used Notion for this. In fact, I still use Notion, a different app to do this. But if you were gonna use Todoist, one of the amazing things is you can do this right inside Todoist. It's a lovely feature. And I can actually just go over here to the view button and I can switch the layout from board to list. And this way I can actually see all of my videos that I'm working on as projects in the same sections, in the same categories, but not as a Kanban board, but just as a list. So I do like to have this one as a Kanban board, but you can see you can also group and sort in exactly the way that you like. So board is my favorite for YouTube videos, but if I wanted to look at a different area, for example, this one right here, I'm going to be getting skydiving certified this summer, so I've got some tasks related to that project. These tasks I'm just showing as a list like this, right? Now, in Todoist, there is, here's a feature called filters and labels. You can set up labels, which is often called tags in different to-do apps, and you can set up filters. Filters are a way of showing you some to-dos and projects, but not others. So one label that's handy, for example, is a someday label that I've set up. To create a new label, you just go here and you give it a name, you can give it a color if you want. And what I can do is I can apply the someday tag or label to a particular to-do, and that is a signal to say, you know what, I'm not gonna get to this anytime soon, but I'd like to do it someday. So here we go. These are some of the tasks that I would like to work on someday, but not anytime soon. So let's go back and filters are very handy. For example, I set up a filter that I call anytime. Now, if I edit that, you can see there's a query and there's help documents that will help you set this up. Basically, what I want to see is all tasks that are either scheduled for today or that are not scheduled for a specific day in the future, right? And so if I click on that, what that's going to show me is tasks that make sense for me to work on anytime, like right now, tasks that might make sense for me to work on right now. This is a really handy view that you can go in when you're planning your day, in the morning, the night before, and see what are all the things I could do, and then select some tasks and put them on the list for today or tomorrow if you're doing it the night before that you're gonna work on. So it really helps you plan effective, productive days. Now, there's a lot more you can do with filters and labels, but I just want you to be aware that that exists. There's also a really nice feature inside Todoist that is location-based reminders. Now, this does not work on the Mac, but if you go on your iPhone, your iPad, or on Android, what you can do when you're entering a new task or when you're editing an existing task, you can actually set a reminder, not just to be reminded of you know, that you need to do this thing at a specific time, but also when you arrive at a specific place. So that can be super handy. You know, when I get to the airport, exchange some currency, something like that. I use that all the time in other apps. It's a lovely feature. Very happy that Todoist supports this. Now, next up, I want to talk about collaboration. It's hard for me to show you that because I'm not using Todoist in a collaborative way, but remember earlier that I showed you this comments feature right here? The reason this exists is because I can leave a comment on a task, but I can also invite other people into my Todoist space, and then they can comment on tasks. I can assign tasks to them. They can assign tasks to me. I don't like it when people assign tasks to me, but that's something that you can do. And then, of course, you can create filters. You can say, what are all the tasks that have not been assigned to anyone yet, you know, and you can make it like a daily thing or a weekly thing that you look at those and make sure you assign those to a member of your team. So if you have a small team, Todoist might be a really great way to organize tasks within your team, especially because Todoist is available on all platforms. Now, if you're working with a really big team, like 50 people, then Todoist probably is not going to be the right choice for you. You might want to look at different software like a Basecamp or something like that. But for smaller teams, Todoist might be really good. Okay. I want to talk a little bit about integrations with other apps, and then we're going to talk about some downsides of Todoist, and then I'll give you my final thoughts. Integrations with other apps. Now, if I go back to Google Chrome, there's actually a page on the Todoist website where it shows you integrations that they have with other apps. So you can go there. It's todoist.com/integrations, I guess. Right here is an Outlook integration. I was talking to a buddy of mine who really uses Outlook a lot for his small business, and he loves this integration. So let me just show you here how that works without setting it up, because I don't use Outlook myself. Basically, whether you're using Outlook on the web, on desktop, or mobile, you can actually set this up, and it creates a button where you can quickly add a task to Todoist about the email that you're looking at. So if someone emails you, hey, can you do this for me? What you can do is quickly add it to Todoist. And you can either send it directly to the inbox, or you can say, you know what, I'm going to change the name, I'm going to assign it to a certain project, I'm immediately going to add the due date, maybe add a label, etc. So that could be super, super helpful. Now, another integration that I think is pretty cool is that Todoist actually exists for Chrome. Here you go. You see that Todoist sits in my Chrome right here. So here I'm looking at a web page. I'm flying to Thailand in a few days, and I'm going to get an eSIM so that I have cellular data when I get to Thailand, and I need to set that up. I need to book that or buy the eSIM. I'll just click Todoist in the browser. Now, it usually takes a second to pop up. There it is. And what I can do is I can click Add Website as Task. So this website I'm looking at, there you go. So what I can do is actually say, buy Thailand eSIM at, and then I can change the project if I want. So I can say it's an admin thing, boom. And now what happens is inside Todoist, so let's pull Todoist back up. This is a task that is on my list for today. Now, if I want to, I can actually format this a little bit nicer. I can grab this and cut it and say, buy Thailand eSIM, and I can actually turn this into a link. So this is a pretty dope feature for Todoist, to be honest with you. Click save, and now this is a link. So that's very cool, right? I can just click this and it bumps me right back to this website that I was looking at. Anyway, Todoist has some really nice integrations. So there's a couple of things I wanna talk about that are downsides for Todoist, right? Because Todoist is not perfect. Now, the biggest downside to Todoist is it does not support the concept of start dates. So in Todoist, if we just look at a task, you'll see that there's only one type of date. So for example, right here, by Thailand Eastern, I set the due date at today. But actually, it's not due today. I'm flying to Thailand on Saturday. I'd like to do this before I fly. So really, the due date should be Saturday. But if I do that, what Todoist is going to do is the task is no longer here. And it's actually scheduled for, if I keep going, it's scheduled for Saturday. But I don't always want to do tasks last minute. That's not a great way to go through life. So unfortunately, I would like there to be a separation where I can say, well, it has to be done Saturday at the latest, but I'm planning to work on it today. There's not a great way to do this in Todoist. There's a couple workarounds that you can try. I've tried them myself. For example, I've created a next tag, if you're familiar with that. I've tried to create a label that is a deadline label, but I didn't really like that because it starts to circumvent some of the other cool features that exist in Todoist, like the calendar synchronization. So that's definitely one downside. But if that's not something that you care about a lot, hey, don't worry about it. I'm gonna set this task back to today because I don't wanna forget about it. I need to do that today. The repeating task functionality inside Todoist is a bit opaque. There is a repeating task functionality. So let's say I'm gonna create a task and I'm going to say, leave a tip for housekeeping every day. That's easy. It recognizes every day and it automatically makes that repeat. But if you click here, you see you cannot set up the repetition here. So the only way that you can set up the repetition for a task is by using natural language. And that gets pretty complicated. You can say like every third Friday of the month. That doesn't make sense for this, but I could say like, you know, submit my timesheet or something like that. It recognizes this, but you have to really know how to spell out in natural language what repetition you want. And there's also different ways of writing this depending on whether you want to repeat it on a standard schedule or whether you want to do something, let's say, 3 days after I completed the previous time. So it gets complicated. Anyway, my point is, there's great documentation for all of this, but it's not super intuitive. Another thing is that the widgets for Todoist on iOS are pretty bland. I haven't tested the Android widgets because I don't have an Android phone. I'm not that much of a cool YouTuber yet that people are sending me free Android phones. Hopefully we'll get there at some point. That'd be fun. So I can carry even more stuff with me as I travel. I'm traveling full time now. But anyway, the widgets on iOS are pretty bland. It's just a list of tasks and you can customize what you show in the widget. There's some decent customization options, but I find that they're not very fun to look at. And yeah, it matters to me whether my to-do app looks pretty. So now another thing I want to mention as a downside for Todoist is not the best for very large projects. So for example, right now I'm running an online course called Organize Your Life. It's a live course. We've got 30 something people in the course. It's very fun. Got meetings all the time. And I don't have a ton of tasks left for this course, but when I started working on this course, it was a really big project with a lot of small things to do. And you'll see that Todoist, like, it can handle, you can put as many tasks in this project as you want. But each task takes up quite a bit of space. So when you have lots and lots and lots of tasks, it just starts to feel a little bit cramped. And other apps do a better job at letting you drill into specific parts of projects or in letting you hide certain things than Todoist. This is maybe a minor quibble, but if you're someone who has lots of simultaneous projects, you might prefer to use a different app like an OmniFocus that lets you drill down and focus on certain things better. Todoist also does not support the concept of sequential projects, by the way, if you know what that is. So should you use Todoist? Well, the reason I said that you should consider using Todoist is that Todoist is great for some people, but not for other people. Personally, I don't use Todoist. I use a different app called Things3. I have lots of videos and an entire course on Things3 if you're interested in that. Actually, I have been using Todoist for the last couple of weeks alongside Things3 just so I could get really familiar with Todoist and give you the best information on it as possible. But that's not something I recommend for anyone. That's only for productivity teachers like myself. Now, if you like to have a very simple interface for your to-do app, if you have a small team, perhaps, that you'd like to share tasks with, if you want a to-do list app that's available on any platform, on every platform, and if you just like the idea of having your to-do list app integrate really well with your calendar, and if you have very calendar-driven days, Todoist might be an excellent choice for you. It might be the best choice for you. I hope this helps you decide. Please like the video if you found it useful. And if you want me to create a more tutorial style video where I show you how to organize Todoist, how to set it up, do let me know in the comments below. In the meantime, have a great day. Thanks for watching. Ciao.